In this video, I'll show you 7 advanced Nano Banana image editing tips that will help you get professional level results. I'm Terrence. Over the past 3 years, I've generated over 100,000 images using AI and over 1,000 images using Nano Banana. And these are the most effective techniques that help me get top tier results. Keep watching because the first tip completely solves everyone's frustrations with the aspect ratio. And one of these tips will help you recreate any style and composition from any image on the internet. By the time we're done, you'll have professional level image editing results using just natural language. So let's dive in. Tip number one is controlling the aspect ratio. So I see a lot of users complaining about Nano Banana always giving them the square images or basically only copying the aspect ratio of the image they provided, even if they specifically told it to turn this image into a 16:9 image or a 9:16 image and so on. So the solution is to include an image with the aspect ratio that you want. So to show you this in action, I have this 9:16 image here, and you might not be able to see it, but if we click here, there's actually a transparent 16:9 image. What I told Nano Banana is to expand and fill the first image to the entire width and height of the second image, and I got this result. Now the image is 16:9. So step by step, how this works is you look for an image that has your desired aspect ratio. Ideally, it's blank or plain, so it doesn't implement or add any elements to the image you're expanding. And then you upload the main image first. In this case, the image we want to expand, this one. And then you upload the reference image last. This is important because, again, as I mentioned, Nano Banana uses the last uploaded image's dimension as reference. And then finally, you have to prompt. And what I've found in order for this to work is the reference image has to be included in some way. So whether you ask them to blend the image or you ask Nano Banana to copy the aspect ratio of the last image, etc. Because I've tried this multiple times with uploading 2 images and just asking it to expand the aspect ratio of the image, and it doesn't work. I have to mention the reference image in some way. But prompting it is pretty simple. You just have to say, for example, expand the image to have the aspect ratio of the second image, or put the logo on the first image, on the cup on the second image. And as long as the second image has the desired aspect ratio that you want, then you're golden. Now that we have the biggest headache out of the way, let's get into a tip shared by a viewer of this channel on how you can get Nano Banana to generate images in batches. So how I discovered this tip is because on my other video where I compare Nano Banana and Seedream, linked up there, I had the head-to-head test there where I asked both Nano Banana and Seedream to generate images in batches. And I wasn't able to get Nano Banana to generate multiple images in one prompt, but I was able to easily get Seedream to generate it. But RJMCTV actually dropped a comment on how to do that, and I tested it out and it works great. So thank you, RJ, for sharing the sauce. So for batch generation, what you have to do is upload your base image and you have to structure your prompt with numbered variations. Let me show you how that works. So this is actually the exact same prompt that RJ provided. I just put the cup here, but it basically says to generate add mockups from the attached image and showing the cup in 4 environments. And then I defined each environment here. So community center, shopping mall, airport, church, and to ask it to preserve brand consistency. And Nano Banana did generate me 4 separate images in one go. So this is the community center. We see the cups here, and also airport and a church. So I tested this out with a character, a picture of me. So I refined the prompt in some way, but I noticed that the important parts are to mention the different images, in this case different identities, and to one by one mention what identity you want. In this case, knight, wizard, scholar, and blacksmith. And these are the images I got, and they're pretty solid, even if I asked Nano Banana to generate the images in batches. I wish I had guns like that. That'd be nice. Soon! But what if you want variations, but you're not sure which variations you want? You're just playing around. Here, I asked Nano Banana to generate images of the cup in 4 different coffee shops, and I just said coffee shop 1, coffee shop 2, coffee shop 3, or in coffee shop 4, and it generated me 4 different images of different coffee shops. So again, for the step-by-step, you just have to upload your base image. You structure the prompt with the numbered variations. You specify consistency requirements for the main subject, like keep the features of the cup the same or keep the facial features of the man the same. And then you define the different environments for each variation. So sample prompts are here. These are the exact same prompts I showed you in the chat conversations. Now that we've solved the efficiency problem of getting Nano Banana to generate multiple images, let's get into specific image editing tips to give you more flexibility, consistency, and control over your edits. So the third tip is to use flexibility or consistency phrases. I talked about this previously in my Nano Banana capabilities video, but it's really worth mentioning again because these tips just make image editing with Nano Banana so much easier. By consistency phrases, I mean basically saying keep the same X or being more specific with it, like saying keep the same outfit, keep the same face, camera angle, lighting, or simply saying keep everything else the same. And for flexibility prompts, this is the other way around, right? Where you want Nano Banana to naturally adapt the images based on what you're editing. So for example, if you're asking the man to be put in a thunderstorm, then you would want the lighting to naturally adapt the thunderstorm or rainstorm lighting, right? So you can simply say edit the characteristics of the person to fit X, like edit the appearance of the person to fit the overall aesthetic, or my favorite one is actually with natural lighting and realistic placements. And again, these aren't strict templates. You are free to explore because Nano Banana is built on Gemini, right? And Gemini is a large language model. And these models have very good understanding of words. So as long as you ask it to keep something consistent or to adapt it, then it should get the idea. What's important is that you give it that specific instruction so that it understands what you want. And a pro tip here that I found works really well is to combine a flexibility phrase with the consistency phrase in your prompts. Like the example I have here of this man in this dashing olive. Is that olive? Olive. I'm bad with colors. Which is why I have another tip which we'll be covering next that will solve this color issue. But for now, yes, we have this man in an olive suit. And I asked to transform this person into a medieval knight to edit their appearance to fit the overall aesthetic with natural lighting and realistic placement, but to keep their face recognizable and keep everything else the same. And this is what we got. Now he's wearing armor, and you can see even the lighting on the armor blended super well to the environment, right? We can see that the sun is indeed coming from here, and the lighting is reflecting that on the armor. So absolutely sublime how Nano Banana did this. And another tip I found super helpful is if the face of the subject drifts, then you can simply say restore original facial features from the first image and keep everything else the same. For example, this one, I asked Nano Banana to change the aspect ratio and the expression to a happy surprise. So I got this, but it doesn't really look like me anymore. So I asked to restore original facial features from the first image. And then this is what I got. Now, given it didn't follow the expression I wanted, but this looks a lot similar to the reference image I provided here. So consistency or flexibility is great. But what if you want to implement accurate color in your edits? Then we have tip number 4, which is to use hex codes for precise color. So I'm sure everybody knows what hex codes are. Implementing this tip is super simple. You just have to identify your color hex codes and then include the hex specifications when asking for color edits. So why this works is because Nano Banana or language models in general respond to precise technical specifications of colors better than vague color descriptions. So we have this dashing image of me again. So I could have asked Nano Banana to just say change the man's shirt color to red, and I would have gotten a similar result, right? But if we check this hex color here, now we can see that it is this specific shade of red. And then I asked Nano Banana to again change to a different color. This time I picked a color that isn't that specific, like a different shade of yellow. Now if we compare this side by side, you can see that it is indeed super accurate, right? We have this shade of yellow here. And it would have been difficult to get this result if we just asked Nano Banana to say, change a man's color to yellow. Again, I just kept on building up on it. I said, put a lamp beside the man. The lamp should emit a light in this color. And if we check this color, it's this shade of blue. So yeah, that tip is pretty straightforward and specific. Instead of saying red, define the specific hex color of red. Now that's it for color accuracy, but what if you want precision in your composition? Lighting and effects like a laser. Of course, that's why we love Nano Banana, right? It's precise, but we can make it more precise through the use of photography terminology. Gemini is very smart. It's trained on a lot of professional photography datasets, so technical terms activate more sophisticated rendering pathways in its beautiful AI brain. You can use different professional terms like camera specs. You can define what lens to use, lighting. You can use different lighting setups. These are just samples. There's obviously a ton out there, and if you're a photographer, this is going to be especially powerful for you because now you can basically be the director, right? So there's some sample prompts here, and in action here we fed the image that we fixed the aspect ratio earlier, and we asked Nano Banana to change the lighting of the image to golden hour lighting. Since it has understanding of photography terminology, then it updated the lighting on that image. Then I said to zoom into an eye level shot of the girl riding the horse, and it gave us this. Another example is turning this eyeliner into a lifestyle photography shot. So you can see here's the prompt to turn this into a product photography shot, but I specified the macro lens perspective and the aperture and softbox key lighting from a 45 degree angle. The results are just pretty. If I owned this product, which I don't use eyeliner, this would be up on the website. And for sure, you would have gotten better results using this prompt than just maybe using this prompt without defining the different photography terminologies. Now you have the foundational tips for consistency or flexibility, color precision, and photography terminology. These next tips build up on the previous ones and allow you to create more holistic images and even to stack these tips together. So tip number 6 is step-by-step editing, which is basically doing one clear and focused edit at a time. So why this works is that each edit maintains context while allowing focused adjustments so that Nano Banana doesn't get confused. So to show you this in action, we have this image of this man here with the cool earphones and nice sunglasses. Now, I first asked Nano Banana to zoom out the image, which it did pretty easily here. Now it's zoomed out. And then to change the background to a modern office setting with large windows, which it did here. And then to adjust the lighting to match the golden hour sunlight coming from the windows. So we can see here, the lighting was adjusted. Now this is, again, I used the photography terminology here. And then the next prompt, I used the color precision tip, which is to change the color of the man's sunglasses frame to this specific color. And it did that beautifully. As you can see, this is like not a common shade of red, right? I was very specific with it. So I said to zoom out the image in the half body shot. And again, Nano Banana maintains the entire context, right? We have the lighting that we put in. We have the color of the shades. We have the environment or the background here. So for step-by-step edits, you simply have to start with one clear focused edit, check your results and see if you're happy with it, and then specify the next improvement. Now, multi-step editing is great, but what if you want to recreate a specific image that you saw on the internet but don't know where to start? That's where we get into tip number 7, which is reverse engineering images. In order to do this, you simply have to upload a reference image that has the style and mood you want to replicate, then ask Nano Banana for a concise but detailed prompt of the image, and then you simply have to refine the prompt that it gave you. So over here is a Midjourney image that I really like the style of it. So I asked Nano Banana to analyze this image and create a concise but detailed prompt that would generate a similar style or mood. Then it gave me this prompt. Now what I did was to start a conversation and gave it the prompt. and I just edited a couple of elements, like an image of this man instead of a woman. The results I got are, yeah, very similar to the reference image I provided it. So this is the image that was generated from the prompt, and this was the original image. Very similar. Again, another example is I really like how this image was done. So again, I asked, describe this image as if you were giving prompting instructions to recreate the aesthetic, lighting, style, and visual approach. Nano Banana gave me this prompt. I fed it my picture, gave it the prompt, and then I got this. Again, very similar to the initial image style. And a pro tip here is to use the image directly as a reference even. So you can say create an image of a man in the first image, similar to the style and composition of the second image. And when I tried that out, so I fed Nano Banana this image and my dashing picture, and it gave me this. Again, very similar style. It did it beautifully. I mean, I think this was even more accurate, actually, from what I want. It copied the fish almost exactly from here. I'm constantly discovering, testing, and sharing these new techniques and tips and tools as they emerge. So subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want more insights and tutorials like this. And if you're interested in a deep dive between Nano Banana and Seedream, one of the other top AI image editors, then make sure to check out this video.